Hello, my dear children. Today we are going to discuss about salts. So, when you hear the term salt, which salt will come into your mind first? Definitely it is sodium chloride, right? How does sodium chloride form? We know that when sodium hydroxide, the base, reacts with hydrochloric acid, it's a base, hydrochloric acid, okay? We know that sodium chloride and water are produced, right? Sodium chloride and water are produced. This is a salt. Sodium chloride is a salt and water are produced. So, this reaction is having a particular name, which is that, yes, it is called neutralization reaction. Okay. Why this reaction is called a neutralization reaction? Because when an acid and a base react each other, they will try to neutralize each other, and as a result, two neutral compounds, sodium chloride and water, are produced. In this chemical reaction, we have taken a strong base and a strong acid. Therefore, the salt formed will be having a pH 7, which is neutral in nature. Before going to that, we will write the chemical formula of some of the salts. So, you will get familiar with the chemical formulas of those salts. Okay, you have already learned how to write the chemical formulas using the valencies in class 9, isn't it? So I have written a lot of salts on the board. See the first one, potassium sulfate. How to write potassium sulfate? Potassium K and sulfate is SO4, right? So how to write? You know that the valency of sulfate, the polyatomic ion sulfate, is 2. Therefore, we are always writing, swapping around the valencies, right? So, before going to that session, let us discuss some of the common salts, okay? So, before going to that session, we will discuss some of the salts and how to write the chemical formula of those salts, which you already learned in class 9. Okay, so I have written some of the examples, some examples of salts on the board. Let's try to write the chemical formula of those salts. Okay, so first, potassium sulfate. In class 9th, you have already learned how to write the chemical formula, isn't it? So how to write? First, we have to write the valency. Sorry, first we have to write the symbol. Okay, symbol. Symbol of potassium is K. Sulfate is a polyatomic ion, so SO4, right? Then what next? We have to write the valency. Valency of potassium is 1 and sulfate is, polyatomic sulfate ion is 2. Therefore, we will swap around the valencies so that you will get potassium sulfate, K2SO4. If it is 1, we will not write that. Okay. What about sodium sulfate? How will you write? Sodium sulfate also, Na2SO4, right? Because sodium is having valency 1, sulfate is having valency 2. So, we will exchange the valencies. Calcium sulfate, calcium valency 2. So, both of them are having valencies 2. Therefore, we will write CaSO4. Okay? So, we will write like this. Okay? Potassium sulfate, I will write here K2SO4. What is sodium sulfate? Na2SO4. Calcium sulfate? calcium valency 2, sulfate is also having valency 2, therefore CaSO4. How to write magnesium sulfate? Magnesium valency 2, sulfate also having valency 2, therefore MgSO4. Copper sulfate, copper shows variable valencies, different valencies because it's a transition element, but normally valency is 2, therefore CuSO4. Sodium chloride, we know that NaCl, sodium valency 1, chlorine is also having valency 1. Sodium nitrate, how will you write? Sodium nitrate, sodium valency 1, polyatomic ion nitrate is also having valency 1, therefore NaNO3. Hydroxide and sulfuric acid. Okay, we'll write all the names of the bases and salts first, then we will decide the nature. Alright, so here the next one, magnesium sulfate. So here the base is magnesium hydroxide, MgOH twice, and sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Okay, then copper sulfate, copper hydroxide, sulfuric acid. Next, potassium sulfate, potassium hydroxide, and sulfuric acid. Sodium nitrate, sodium hydroxide, nitric acid, HNO3. And the last one, sodium carbonate. So, sodium hydroxide and carbonate, carbonic acid, H2CO3. Okay, H2CO3. Is that clear? Okay. Now, let's try to write the nature of the salt. See here, sodium sulfate is formed from a strong base and a strong acid. Therefore, it is also neutral. The third one, calcium sulfate. See, calcium hydroxide is a weak base and sulfuric acid is a strong acid. Therefore, what is the nature of the salt formed here? It will be acidic because weak base and strong acid, therefore acidic. Here, magnesium hydroxide and sulfuric acid will form magnesium sulfate, right? So, the nature of magnesium sulfate also will be acidic, because it is formed from weak base and a strong acid. Is that clear? Next one, say weak base and strong acid. So acidic. What is the salt? Copper sulfate, right? Copper sulfate. Then potassium sulfate. Look here. Potassium hydroxide is a very strong base. Sulfuric acid is also a strong acid. Therefore, it will be neutral. Okay, what about sodium nitrate? Look here, sodium hydroxide is strong, nitric acid is also strong, therefore this will be sodium nitrate is also neutral. Look at the last one, sodium carbonate. It is formed from a strong base but a weak acid. Carbonic acid is weak. So what will be the nature? It is formed from strong base and a weak acid. Therefore, the nature of the salt will be basic. So, from these examples, we can conclude that when a strong acid and a strong base react to each other, a neutral salt is formed. But when a strong acid and a weak base react to each other, the salt formed will be acidic. And when a strong base and a weak acid react to each other, the salt formed will be basic in nature. So remember, all salts are not neutral. So it depends upon the nature of acid and base from which that salt is formed. The nature of the salt also may vary to acidic, basic or neutral. Okay, now let's move about discussing salts. The first salt that we are going to discuss is the common salt, sodium chloride. As we know, common salt that we are obtaining usually from seawater, and the second resource of sodium chloride is rock salt. Okay, rock salt is like coal,
I mean natural deposit inside the soil, inside under the earth. Rock salt usually contains a lot of impurities so that it appears as a brown color. Sodium chloride is a raw material for various chemicals that we are going to see. Okay, let's move to sodium chloride. The common salt is a raw material for many different types of chemicals like sodium hydroxide, chlorine, hydrogen, washing soda, baking soda, many more. Okay, so we are going to discuss all these in detail today. Look on the board. You know that common salt is having a chemical formula sodium NaCl, sodium chloride NaCl, right? So an aqueous solution of sodium chloride, okay, which is called brine. What is this? Aqueous solution of sodium chloride. Sodium chloride mixed with water, which is called brine. Okay. When electricity is passed through brine, okay, electricity is passed through brine, this solution will decompose into three different products. One is sodium hydroxide, which is a strong base. We know a lot of uses are there for sodium hydroxide that we are going to discuss what are the uses of sodium hydroxide. And hydrogen gas and also chlorine gas are produced. Okay, now electricity is when electricity is passed through brine. Three products are produced. What are they? Sodium hydroxide, which is a strong base, chlorine gas and hydrogen gas. Okay, and hydrogen gas will be during electrolysis, it is deposited at cathode, and chlorine gas is deposited at anode, and sodium hydroxide is deposited near to cathode. Okay, that we are going to discuss in detail what are the uses. Now, this particular chemical reaction is having a name which is called chloralkali process, which is very important. Chloralkali process. What is chloralkali process? Electrolysis of brine to produce sodium hydroxide, okay, hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. This particular chemical reaction is called chloralkali because alkali, sodium hydroxide is produced, chlorine is also produced. Okay, all of them are having a lot of uses in various industries that we are going to discuss. We are going to discuss about the uses of the products formed by chloralkali process. I have written on the board, you can see three products are formed by chloralkali process. Hydrogen at cathode is negative electrode, okay, electrolysis process, no? So cathode will be there, anode will be there. So cathode, negative electrode, hydrogen gas will be produced, and at the positive electrode, anode, chlorine gas will be formed, and near to the cathode, sodium hydroxide is also deposited. Alright, so we can see a lot of uses for each product. For example, hydrogen gas is used as a fuel and to make margarine, a butter-like substance, cheese-like, butter-like substance, hydrogen is used, and hydrogen is also used for making ammonia. Ammonia is used for making fertilizers. Ammonia, what is ammonia? NH3, isn't it? So nitrogen and hydrogen combine together to form ammonia. Okay, now moving to chlorine, which is produced at anode, we have a lot of uses. Water treatment to disinfect water, chlorine is used. For the same purpose, we are using chlorine in swimming pools, and also to make PVC, polyvinyl chloride, which is a plastic, the chlorine is used. CFC, chlorofluorocarbon, okay, CFC, chlorine is there. Pesticides, okay, to make pesticides, chlorine is used. Now moving to sodium hydroxide, which is formed near to the cathode. It is used for degreasing metals, to remove grease from metals, sodium hydroxide can be used. Then it is used to make soaps and detergents, and it is used to make paper making, and also in artificial fibers. Okay, the uses are not limiting here. When hydrogen and chlorine combine together, we know the second type of products are also there, and some more uses are also there. Okay, here you can see when hydrogen and chlorine combine each other, you will get hydrochloric acid, which is a very important raw material for various industries. You can see for cleaning steel, hydrochloric acid is used. For preparing the salt, ammonium chloride, okay, hydrochloric acid is used. Ammonium chloride is a salt formed from ammonium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. And also hydrochloric acid is used in various medicines, and also to prepare a lot of cosmetics, hydrochloric acid is used. Now let's move to the next one, bleaches. Okay, they are formed when chlorine combines with, or chlorine is treated with, sodium hydroxide. Okay, so bleaches, as we know, household bleaches are there, and also bleaches for fabrics are there. Okay, so now these are all about the products, the uses of the products of chloralkali process. In the coming classes, we will discuss about some more salts like washing soda, baking soda, gypsum, plaster of Paris, etc. Okay, so hope you understood well. Till chloralkali process, we'll continue in the coming class. Till then, take care and bye bye.